Welcome to the first tutorial covering the use of Curvy version 2.0. In this video, we will be covering the basics, importing the asset, introducing some bits of the interface, and creating a first spline. Importing the asset into your project is very straightforward. Just wait for the asset store download to complete and start the process in the import window. If you have no use for sample assets, you can simply exclude the Curvy examples folder from the list. I'll skip to the end of the import process now. The first thing you might notice right after the import process is complete is the toolbar appearing in the corner of the scene view. It exposes a lot of the functionality in the package and aids in spline editing. We will take a comprehensive look at all the toolbar contents later. For now, let's check the Options tab. It allows you to open the editor preferences, the online manual, the official website, the bug reporting page, and the About window. Editor preferences allow you to customize almost every aspect of Curvy, including the look of the toolbar itself. And the About window contains the version information, which is very important to mention in the support requests, by the way, and yet more useful links, for example, to the API reference. But let's get to the point of this package, creating splines. We'll study them in depth in the next video, but for now, let's take a look at one and then try to create our first simple spline. Every spline consists of a spline object, that is, a game object with a Curvy spline component attached, and a set of control points, that is, game objects with a Curvy spline segment component attached. Control point objects are parented to a spline object. Connecting those control points gives us a spline curve. So, we have two simple tasks, creating a spline object and creating a set of control points under it. You can create a spline object in a number of ways. For example, you can simply create an empty game object and then attach a spline component to it using the standard Add Component menu, like you see here. Alternatively, you can use the context menu of the Scene Hierarchy tab. You'll find a new set of actions here, called Curvy, offering you to create a spline, among some other things. So, you can create a spline object using the same steps you use with any other Unity component. As we'll see shortly though, you are not required to. While control points, as I've said above, are simply other game objects with another component attached, creating them manually is not recommended. You probably do not want to plug in references manually or to maintain proper hierarchy, naming of game objects, ordering in reference lists, and many other things required in a proper spline setup. So, we just made an editor tool, which does all that and more for you. Take another look at the toolbar. We have a Draw Spline button there, which opens up a small panel with two status icons and three buttons. Let's say we want to add a few control points on the horizontal plane. Simply select the plane using the appropriate button, hold Ctrl, and click in the scene view. Now, perfectly configured control points are instantly created on a plane we have selected, under a spline we have selected. Better yet, if you do not have any spline objects selected, the tool works anyway and creates a new spline object for you. So, if you don't feel like it, you can skip the manual spline object creation altogether and just Ctrl-click in the scene view whenever you want a new spline. We'll cover the options available in the spline component and some more complex operations with control points, for example, insertion of a new control point into an existing path, in the next video. For now, thanks for watching!